earlier when we started doing these live streams. Hi, everyone. Good to see you. That we are going to do some really fun and neat stuff here with these live streams. So today we're out in the backyard having wine and enjoying a nice spring evening. What degrees is it, would you say?
I think 75, maybe.
Okay, 75 degrees.
Absolutely beautiful.
And so we're going to do something really different tonight. Kim's going to be on the chat. I'm going to be right here next to her. And we are going to stay put right here in this position. We are not going to do Q's and A's, question-answer things, unless we absolutely need to. But what we thought would be really fun to do tonight is to make this live chat all about you. All about you guys. And so we thought that would be a fun way to change things up. So what we're going to do tonight is really, I don't know that it's ever been done before, but what we're going to do is we're going to make tonight's episode all about you. And so what we're going to do shortly is ask you what you're excited about out in your garden right now, what's something you're really proud of, or what's something that's you're really, worried about, or, you know, kind of a challenge for you. So we just think it'd be really fun to make this one just all about you gardeners. So we're going to do it in three steps. So we're going to try it like this first. We are going to, I'm going to stop before we get going. Can someone just tell me how the sound is, please? Just let me know if you can hear us okay. And report down in the chat, please. If you hear us, fine, and we should proceed. Or if we should make a major adjustment or something, because we really can't test this. We don't really know how. Kim's going to tell me when somebody replies back and says, yeah, we hear you nice and loud and clear. So could someone please just chat up and let us know how we sound, okay? So I'm going to go ahead and proceed as if we sound good, because I'm not getting any.
I haven't heard anything yet. So.
All right, so we're going to proceed.
Oh, good sound.
Okay,
Josh,
good sound.
Josh said good sound. Thanks, Joshua.
Beautiful. Thanks, Josh. Josh is always quick on the uptake there. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to talk to the people who are still under snow. People who haven't had the chance to get out into the soil yet and plant. So maybe you're growing stuff indoors, etc. So we're going to talk to that group first, and we're going to turn it over to you. And you're going to tell us what you're doing, and we're going to chat back with you. The second group we're going to talk to is the group that has had the chance to plant. We're going to ask you, okay, tell us about what's going on. The third group we're going to talk to is the group that plants all year round. And then you can have the stage for a little bit and tell us what you're doing. Okay, does that sound good?
Sounds good.
Okay, so all of you out there in internet land, live stream land, the question is can you do it? I think we can do this in an organized fashion. So here we go. We're going to start talking first, and Kim's on the chat here. We're going to start talking first to the folks who are still not planting, whether it's just your ground's frozen or you're under snow. What are you excited about? Start chatting now. Kim's going to address you and speak to me and that kind of thing. What is it that you're excited about planting this spring? What are you just itching to do? Okay, so I'm going to see what's going on in the chat wise. Kim is going to tell us if anyone answers back. So if you're answering our question back, go to all caps or something so we know that you're answering the question, and that is for those of you who have not planted yet, what are you excited about? What are you nervous about? Or maybe you're doing indoor growing and you're about to jump over to, you know, transfer from the peat pellets into cups and stuff. Hey, I actually sound pretty good right there.
Pretty good.
All right, so what do we got? Anyone yet?
So far, I have incredible low. It says, just getting hit by another snowstorm today, but inside cozy with your tomato seedlings.
Who is this?
This is incredible low.
Incredible low.
Nothing like a cozy night with your tomato seedlings when it's snowing outside, right?
Hit by another snowstorm.
That's crazy.
I can't fathom that. Oh my gosh. Thanks for the feedback.
Incredible. Where are you located?
Yeah,
like
where are you
located? What state are you in?
Yeah, where are you located? And how much longer till you get, you know, till you get the warm weather?
And Vaughn said, LOL, it's snowing tomorrow. Vaughn Dinger.
Oh my gosh,
that's
what a bummer.
Hard to imagine. Let's see if there's anyone else that. Oh, just planted tomatoes in containers. Let's see. No snow in California.
Who said that in California? This is for the people with snow. right now.
Let me scroll down to the bottom.
We're so lucky in California.
Let's see. I don't have too many other people that talk about snow.
Okay. Anyone else who has not planted yet, this is your time. What are you worried about? What are you excited about doing? This is your time. And the window's closing, and we're going to move on to the next group. Okay?
There's someone who says no snow, but almost underwater in Western Oregon. So,
oh, are you guys getting rain up there?
Must be getting hit with rain, or maybe all the snow is melting. I know you guys had a ton of snow up there this year, so if it's raining and all the rivers are rushing through, then that makes it a little hard, too, to garden if everything's super wet. So snow, rain.
And you know what? For those of you up in the rain, we had that concern, too. When we had the rains, you told me that you were worried about things becoming too soggy.
Yes.
So, yeah, that's definitely an issue there.
We were a little bit worried about the erosion on the hill, and if it might, like, slide down, we might lose some of our raised beds. But so far, so good.
Okay, there's some all caps there. That means they're answering our question.
All caps, tomatoes and pepper. Oh, just want to get my hands in the dirt.
Aw, Mimi, where are you writing from, Mimi? Where are you at? Who is right above her?
Let's see, right above her.
Yeah. Just want to get my hands on that. That's not, I want to plant my rose bush.
I want to plant my rose bush, planting potatoes. So yeah, hopefully it gets warm soon so you guys can get out there. Because man, you have that gardening itch. You just want to scratch it. And when the weather just keeps dragging on and on, it really gets tough.
Oh yeah.
So, you know, I know what you do, what you can do with starting your seedlings indoors, but man, you want to get those things planted. So I really feel for you guys.
Hit the down arrow. Let's see if Mimi answered where she is.
Oh, 26 days of rain so far in March. Wayne. So I'm thinking maybe that's up in Oregon, possibly. Because I know my sister up there says they've been getting hit with a lot of rain and in bad weather, too. So, Eric, let's see.
Oh, Mimi's in Pittsburgh. I was born in Pittsburgh.
Oh, wow, cool. Wow, that's awesome. So Eric Gain, we put up our first greenhouse last week and it's now under snow. Oh my gosh. Won't be even in the 60s until weekend after next.
Oh my goodness.
So in your greenhouse, is it even warm enough to have your seedlings in there? I mean, what do you do? Do you heat it?
Oh,
do you
feel so bad.
Bring everything in if you get those cold temperatures? You know, how does that work in freezing cold temperatures?
Wow, so there are more people than I thought that are battling cold weather still, and you can't get your hands in the dirt, as Mimi said. I love that.
Yeah, that's tough. Yeah. Cleveland, Ohio.
That was...
I've actually heard Ohio is in like 60s and 70s, so maybe hopefully you've been able to get outdoors and get something done this week.
Wow. All right.
Pretty cool.
Hang in there, you guys. Show them some love, all the people who are either in snow or frozen ground. And Mimi, I was born in a homestead area, and we moved out west early in the, let's just say the 60s. We came out west.
We won't say the
but,
exact year.
But a family came over from the Dutch Indies, and we landed in Pittsburgh with a sponsorship from my dad's brother, and then we all headed west with no jobs, and my family started building then. So, that's the story. Sorry,
cool.
a little more than you asked for. All right, I'm seeing some all caps go by. We'll grab some more responses here. We're trying to keep up with them as you scroll by, you guys.
Oh, okay. Eric, I have the flu. Oh, what a bummer. So I'm indoors for now. Okay, well, hopefully you stay warm indoors, but I certainly hope you get better, Eric. That's a bummer.
That counts.
Yeah.
You can't get out there. Hang
in
there.
And Jenna Snow. Well, listen to her name. It should be snowing where she's at. But Jenna says, here in Nevada, it's been cold, rainy with a little bit of snow in Nevada.
Wow.
Oh my gosh, that's crazy.
Wow, there's so many people that are still under snow. I feel so bad.
Yeah, well, hopefully, it does warm up. It is officially spring. So let's hope within a few weeks or a month that you guys are able to get out there, get those seedlings planted, and definitely get them going inside the house for sure, because you want to have those transplants to get into the ground. As soon as that weather warms up, you want those babies going in. So get them going now if you haven't yet.
And another thing, too, is what we really hope to do with our channel is, like, bring you warmth so at least you could watch us and just go, look at Callie Kim. She's in, you know, tank top or in shorts or whatever. Just maybe that'll just kind of get you through until springtime really hits.
So yeah, we'll send a little warmth your way through our channel. So hopefully that helps just encourage you and keep you through the cold weather a little bit.
Okay, well, look at Justin is sacred about planting seedling. Oh, sacred. Scared.
I think you mean scared.
Yeah, okay. But planting for the first time. Right on, Justin.
Way to go, Justin.
Yep, show him some love.
And
first
you know
timer.
What, Justin? hey, get them going. It is kind of scary at first. You don't quite know what to expect. But what I always like to do is plant plenty of backup. So that way,
yes,
if something happens, and it happens to all of us, it happened to me plenty of times, my seedlings have died. What I would do is start a batch now, and then maybe in a week or so, start another batch, just in case that way you have a backup. And you know what? If something happens and they die, you learn. That's how you learn. Don't be afraid to experiment and just learn by doing. That's exactly how I started too. So just encourage you to hang in there and go for it.
All right. So now we are going to move on to the group that has had the chance to plant. Share with
us. Let me say one more thing. MBGC combo. I want the smell of fresh dirt on my hands, but it's flooded and partially covered with snow.
Aww.
Oh my gosh. Hang in there. And there's nothing like getting your hands in the soil, feeling that warmth on your back when you're outside. I think that's part of why we all love to be gardeners. It's like the garden therapy. There's something that's just refreshing and just fills you up. So hang in there. You're going to get there soon, and you'll have your hands in the dirt before you know it.
Okay, so we'll go to the next group, the folks that have had the chance to get out and do a little planting. Or, yeah, there's people planting in the dirt already, right?
Yes.
Or you're starting from seeds indoors. So you could be doing both.
Yes.
You could be doing, okay.
A lot of people doing both, yeah.
Okay, that's why I'm just the camera guy. So let's hear it from you folks. Again, use all caps. And let's hear just from the folks now that have had the chance to plant. What are you super duper excited about? What are you afraid of or a little bit worried about? And we're going to respond to you now. So get those flying in, and again, in all caps and stuff.
So people that have actually planted outside now?
People that have planted outside, yeah. All right, let's see. Beck says, I want to grow Filipino long gourds. I don't know what that is. Please tell me, can I plant? All right, so let's hear from you guys. Tell me. Mango. Someone's asking about mango there, Kim.
Hang on a second, let me.
Banana and mango in California.
Yes, you can. I have never grown banana or mango, but I know that they can be done here. I just wouldn't be able to give you specific advice on that. Have to do a little bit of research and address that one at another time. But I definitely encourage you to do your research. There's plenty of videos out there on that, I'm sure.
Hey, look at that. Pillar Check's on. Rusted Gardener's
on.
Oh,
how cool.
He says, I'm planning.
Hi, Gary.
Kohlrabi.
Kohlrabi. Excellent. Gary's out there getting his kohlrabi planted. How you doing, Gary? Good to see you on here.
Yay.
So while I have Gary here, I got to put a little plug in, guys. Gary and I are doing a collab video series called Gardening Coast to Coast. It's going to be a lot of fun. We're really excited about it. We've been working on it for a while. If you haven't watched the video we just posted yesterday, our very first video in the series, it's all about growing peas. Now, this is not just any pea video because Gary's on the east coast of the U.S. I'm on the west coast. So we have totally different climates, totally different growing zones. And basically, in this series, we're going to show one of us planting seeds and one of us harvesting, because oftentimes he's planting seeds and I'm harvesting. So it'll be a comprehensive video about a specific veggie. So go back and check out that video, and also join our Facebook group called Gardening Coast to Coast, and that way you can get specific information about your growing zone. So head over there, check that out. And let's see who else is planting. Rod. Hi, Rod. How are you? Good to see you on here. He's in Baja. Excited about my first time scarlet runner beans. Those are amazing, and I think they should grow really nice for you in Baja, Rod. They get a little bit too hot for us here, but those are gorgeous, so I can't wait to see your pictures on Instagram. I love those. And they're a super tender variety of bean. They're so, so pretty. So let's see here. Hardcore Gardener. Hi, how are you? Good to see
you. Hey, Rich.
That's nice to see you here. Yeah. Thanks for joining us. He has all his starts in the greenhouse ready to go. Next week, I'll put in some tomatoes and got a spring crop going already. That's awesome. And I know Hardcore Gardener is an amazing gardener. He's been gardening for a really long time, has a lot of experience, has actually helped us, give us a lot of advice
on
our channel.
Rich goes all the way back to the beginning days.
He's been around, since the beginning.
Yep.
So, Rich, that's great. You have a lot going already, and you'll put those transplants right in the ground, and they're going to take off.
Yeah, check him out. Hardcore Gardener, guys. You might like his style.
He's got a lot of cool videos.
He's very knowledgeable.
He is very knowledgeable. Okay, let's see. Who else? Lexi Skiff. I'm located in Missouri. Not much snow this year. You got lucky, Lexi. That's great. It's been cold on and off. Got my beds ready, but still too cold outside. Starting seeds for the first time. So excited. I can almost hear her excitement.
You feel the excitement in that one.
Through her comment. And that is so cool, Lexi. It's so good that you have things going and you're going to be able to pop those in the ground as soon as the weather gets warm. You are ready. So I'm really excited for you.
D.W. Marshall.
D.W. Marshall, hi. Good to see you here. And excited about my habanada pepper. Habanada or habanero? I'm not sure, but habanada is a new one for me. I've never heard that before.
All the flavor without the heat. I like that.
Oh my gosh, that sounds really cool.
I don't have a heat tolerance, man.
I love the heat, but camera guy doesn't. So I think that would be a really cool variety to grow. That sounds really neat.
Very cool.
Okay, Joey Shaleg has tomatoes and Anaheim peppers in the hoop house. That's a great way to start it too. Kind of extend your growing season, doesn't it, Joey? Trying square foot gardening this year. I hope I don't go overboard and choke everything by planting something viney. I've done that so many times. Just cram the plants in there. So, Joey, that's how you learn, right? And the good thing is you can always pull something out if you get too crowded in there.
That's true.
But, man, the hoop house is a great way to get things going a little bit early. So I'm really glad you're getting started. That's great. And Antone, sorry if I didn't say your name right, Webb. I planted peas, beans, tomatoes, peppers, cucumbers, shishito cucumbers. Okay, that's great.
Very cool.
Great to get those going and get them in the ground. It's going to be so much fun to watch them
grow.
This is great. And be able to taste that first harvest. I mean, there's nothing like the very first tomato. That's like my favorite moment of the season, I think.
You get caught up there. I'll talk for a little bit. I just want to say that this is so cool to do because it's always so one-sided. Here, you read there. So you can see what there's more below that blue arrow there if you scroll down. This is so cool to do because it's always just so one-sided when we do a video and stuff. And this is exactly what I was hoping for when I had this idea of just us being able to interact with you guys and hear about you and, like, you know, what you're jazzed about and just, you know, that kind of thing. So it's really cool. It's just really neat.
It's fun.
Especially from where you all are from and stuff. That's really cool, too.
I know. It's cool to see people from all over the place. Okay, so Julie planted over 30 tomatoes.
Wow.
I saw that on Instagram today, Julie. That was crazy. How do you fit all that in? Oh, my gosh, you are going to town. Kale, garlic, spaghetti and acorn squash, zucchini, two varieties of cucumbers, pole beans, corn, and herbs. Julie, you are way ahead of any of us. I know for sure you're way ahead of me. So that's a lot of fun. I want to come over and see your garden and see what kind of 30 varieties of tomatoes you're growing. I would love to see that. It's probably like a tomato forest. So, man, you are always like right on top of things.
Hey, smile, everyone.
Okay, Sarika, tomatoes and peppers in containers. That's a great way to grow. And, man, get those containers planted if you don't have a lot of growing space or we just want to add to your growing space. That's great that you're doing that. You can definitely expand your garden very quickly that way. So, let's see. Julie, good Lord, good luck on your farm. Absolutely,
farm.
Julie. I think
How
you're going to
cool.
be feeding the city where you live with all those tomatoes. That's going to be great.
Sharika?
Right Sharika.
There. Tomatoes and peppers.
Yeah, I just read
you
that
said that?
One.
Okay, sorry.
Yeah, that's okay. Hey, I love Gary Tara. Video and yours. Thanks, Angela. Gary's still on. Way to go, Gary. Joey, onions, potatoes, turnips,
Ooh,
radishes,
turnips.
Kohlrabi, and lettuce bed planted. That's awesome. So you probably have a lot of your cool weather vegetables planted.
Yep.
Which is great to get those started early in the season. If you're not, you know, in the warm weather yet, get those cool weather veggies growing, like the peas, the lettuce, all that kind of stuff.
What's really interesting is I haven't heard anyone share yet, like, keep reading there so you can get queued up. I haven't heard anyone say, like, what they're worried about yet, or, like, I'm really excited about this one particular thing, but I'm kind of nervous because they died last year, or they got eaten last year or something. So be interesting to see what that.
Hey, we got a super chat. Wow, that's exciting. I wasn't even expecting that. Aaron gave us a super chat for $1. Aaron, thank you so much. I appreciate that. If you guys don't know what a super chat is, we'll fill you in. Thank you, Aaron. That's really cool. Underneath the chat window.
We got to reveal who Aaron is, though,
Aaron,
right?
Aaron, can we reveal who you are, or do you want to remain anonymous?
Tell us if we can say who you are,
know.
Aaron. Oh, that is so cool. So Aaron donated $100.
$1.
Aaron donated $1 to us in the Super Chat. And then what that does is it's a certain color, and then his name stays there for a while. and then, you know, then it kind of fades out. But that's what Super Chat's all about. It's just a way for you to show some love for us and all that kind of stuff. So Aaron,
Aaron did
that. I'm scrolling all the way down to see if Aaron answered us.
If you do want to do a Super Chat, there's that little dollar sign. I will. Yeah, hang on.
Yeah, it's a dollar sign. Underwear.
I've never done it before. Congratulations, Aaron. Your first Super Chat and one of our first Super Chats.
Had to try it out.
Way
cool.
To go.
Okay.
Thank you. That's
Thanks,
a lot of
Aaron,
fun.
For doing that. Well, I'm just going to say who you are, okay, Aaron? So Aaron is the husband and the camera guy, if I can say that, for Garden Answer, for Laura over at Garden Answer. So it's cool to have him here, and we just get along so well, we start talking camera stuff. So Aaron, thanks a lot for jumping in, man, and thanks for that dollar. I think I'll be able to get a Snickers or something with that. So
thank you, Aaron.
It's cool to have you here, man. And yeah. If Laura's there with you, tell her I said hi too.
Okay, so here in Beck, in Northwest Arkansas, mint is spreading in my border despite the 40 degrees temperature.
Oh my gosh, 40 degrees.
Oh, that mint is crazy. So yeah, it is invasive. If there's any way that you can plant it in a container, that's definitely the way to go because it will take over and it likes the cool temperature. So it doesn't matter if it freezes, if it's 40 degrees. I have a plant here that's lasted me for probably 5 years, so it's crazy. So yeah, make sure you keep that mint under control because you can get into trouble with that stuff.
The guy from Georgia.
Okay. Shonsky. Whoops, let me scroll up here so I don't miss him.
The scrolling text is fast.
It's flying by here, guys. I planted a bunch of greens here. This is Shonsky 8307. Worried about the heat. It's been in the 80s. Yeah. Oh my goodness. Yeah, the greens, you have to be careful if it's lettuce. Once it gets over 75, it's going to bolt and go to seed. So what I would recommend, if you want a little advice, is try and keep it shaded. If there's any way that you can put a couple stakes over it, maybe shade it with a beach towel or something like that or an old sheet, and that way it'll help it last a little bit longer, last through the heat until the temperatures come down. But that'll definitely extend the life of your lettuce.
All right, keep moving there, honey. You've got a lot to keep going.
Oh,
there.
I know. I just wanted to make sure.
I know.
Okay, in central Pennsylvania.
Yay,
this is
Pennsylvania.
From Blaze Ready. Hi, Blaze. Here, got seeds going. Snow today. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, gosh.
Looking forward to better weather to get the boxes ready. So you're getting your raised boxes ready, your raised beds ready.
Cool.
Hopefully get that warm weather soon so you can get out there and get to planting, right? Okay, Angela, worried about my leggy tomato plants. I hear they don't yield much. If your seedlings are leggy, I would definitely plant another batch because they're not going to be very strong. So get another batch going. Got plenty of time. Don't worry about it, but just get some more going there.
Hey, it's Super Sly.
Super Sly, hi.
I always say that, Super Sly.
We love that name.
Yep.
Super Sly, hi, y'all. Started my green veggies, and I'm afraid of the cabbage worms attacking.
Ooh.
It was a horror show last year, hoping it won't happen again. Those cabbage worms are nasty. So try some row covers. Maybe that'll work. We are actually going to be having a video coming up in the next month or so on something cool that is really helpful against cabbage worms. So stay tuned for that.
Ooh,
don't want to miss
good.
It.
Thanks, okay? Super Sly.
Yeah.
Good to hear from you.
Thanks for tuning in. Okay, so people that are planting now, here's D.W. Marshall growing a bunch of cukes and going to try pickling them for the first time. D.W., if you find a good recipe for pickles, let me know. Mine never turn out good. They're always mushy, except for my refrigerator pickles. So I need a good recipe that'll keep them really crisp. So let me know if you find one, okay? I'd love to hear about it.
I want to address Sarika real quick while you look for your next comment to reply. Sarika says, I live in an apartment, so not much place, but you're doing containers. You guys know what I say when I say containers. When I say apartments, you know who I'm talking about? Mumbai Balcony Gardener.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Gotta go check out her channel. Incredible. She's in the same situation as you, Sarika.
Yeah.
So she just maximizes space, as I'm sure you do as well. You get darn clever at it. So I'm gonna encourage you all to go check them out because it's just a whole different game over there. Mm-hmm. When you just don't have a lot of space. You just get really creative, you go vertically, and I imagine you have stuff in every valuable spot.
Yeah, definitely containers. If you haven't checked out Smart Pots, those things are amazing. Check those out too. So let's see, here we go. In Phoenix, worried about the full sun frying my plants. We go from one extreme to the next, right? From the snow to the full sun. So yeah, Phoenix, that was Chris. Chris, if there's any way you can provide some kind of shade, like they have shade cloths that let through some of the sun, but not all of it, and put that over your plants, that's a good way to go. Because once you get in the hundreds, nothing really grows too well. So give that a try. If that's an option for you, that might be something you want to consider.
Cool, Chris. Thanks for jumping in, man.
Okay, let's see. I saw one about frost date. Let's see. It's flying by. I'm missing stuff here.
Hey, Yvonne.
Oh, Yvonne. Vince. Hi. Thank you for popping on here.
Thanks, Vince.
You know him from Instagram.
Yeah, he is in Montreal.
Very cool.
Cool, bud.
Okay, worried about the squirrels. Oh, those squirrels can get nasty. And by the way, I didn't tell you this. I literally saw a bunny hopping out of my smart pot's lettuce garden today over on my deck over here.
Mm.
So we have had squirrels before, and we don't kill the squirrels. We try and relocate them, which has worked very well for us.
Oh, I can't believe you said that.
And I know, I probably shouldn't say that, right? And we will be trying to relocate the bunny. I'm just going to put it out there because a bunny will decimate my lettuce.
Yep.
And pretty much everything. Okay. Let's see here if we have any other people that are planting. Rod growing peach ghost peppers. Wow, that sounds interesting. I would love to hear more about that. I've never grown super hot, so I'm kind of afraid of them not making it. You know what? I think they're going to be fine in Baja. Mm. I think you're not going to have any problems. You're great at growing peppers. I've seen your peppers on Instagram.
Yeah, Rod.
And you are the pepper man. So I don't have any doubt that your peach peppers are going to be amazing. I can't wait to see pictures.
The pepper man can.
Yes. Okay, let's see. Anyone else? Thanks for all the invite. Great. You're welcome, since Shansky.
All right, okay. So what we're going to do next now is we're going to move on to the third and final group, and that is the group that plants all year round. So we had a little bit of Phoenix, we had some Southern Cal maybe, but so now for us folks who are planting all year round, your guys' time to jump in here. What are you growing? What are you super excited about seeing come out of the ground for you here? And also, you know, what are you afraid of or kind of worried about that you're growing or maybe trying to grow for the first time or something?
Ooh, we got another super chat.
Oh, gosh, another super chatter.
Sweet Charity, trip 007. $5. Thank you so much. And she says, I had to jump in. I'm Eric Gaines' wife. Okay, we heard from Eric a little bit earlier. I'm excited about my garden tower.
Yes.
I'm worried about the animals, raccoons, in my garden the past couple of years.
Oh,
my gosh. I know that's always an issue for us as well. Thank you so much for that super
chat.
Really appreciate it.
That is so nice of you.
Yes, very, very nice of you. Thank you so much for being so considerate. Garden tower. So I'm assuming that's some kind of vertical garden, which is always a really great way to save space. Worried about the animals, raccoons in my garden the last couple of years.
Ooh, we had a raccoon here one time, and then the dog scared him off. Luckily, you know, that can get ugly, but we haven't had him since. So, yeah.
You know, a friend of mine actually recently had a problem with raccoons just decimating her broccoli and cauliflower. Colette, if you're out there, I know she lives near me. She's a good friend of mine. And what she finally ended up doing, because she wasn't able to catch any and live trap them or anything like that, her husband ended up building an electric fence around their garden. Mm. And she said that's working pretty well so far. So I don't know if that's something to consider with the space that you have. They have a couple of raised beds. It worked really well for them. And so far, it's kept the animals out. So maybe you want to try that.
Good luck.
Keep us
posted, because we're going to definitely do this night again midsummer and or early summer and just see how everyone's doing. Because this is an absolute blast.
Very fun.
It's really nice to hear what everyone else is doing, too, and what they're struggling with, too. So we know that our battles are all kind of the same. So.
Can you make the chat bigger? There we go. Yeah. Okay. Okay, so I actually saw right here, scroll by, from Mumbai Balcony Gardener.
Oh, Sharon.
Thank you so much.
Yay.
Was watching quietly since you guys were talking U.S.-specific growing.
Oh.
Hey, we love to have people from all over the world, Mumbai, and we definitely always love it when you're on. She's such an amazing, amazing gardener and amazing friend. Since you guys are talking U.S., thanks a bunch for the kind mention. You're so welcome. Currently, we're above 100 degrees. Plants are in survival mode.
Oh, my gosh.
Mumbai, maybe you can give us some advice. What do you do when things get over 100 degrees? I know you're gardening on a balcony, but do you try and shade things? Do they get shade naturally from your house or from your apartment? But that would be awesome if you could, you know, chime in and tell us, you know, maybe some tips keeping them well watered. Anything that you can contribute, that would be, I would love to hear from you.
Hey, another, what are they called?
Super chat.
Another super
chatter. From Aya
Kang. That's so nice of you guys.
Thank you so much, Aya. Really appreciate that. That's amazing. That just really touches me that people...
Yeah, it does.
Yeah, it's really cool. Thank you so much. So let's see. People that are growing year-round.
Any more folks growing year-round? What are you excited about? Sometimes you try something new, you know, so you're kind of like nervous about it, but you're going for it. So
yeah, that's always fun.
Yeah. Let us know.
Oh, someone here at Sweet Charity gave a little piece of advice about the animals. I have lights with sensors to run them off. Hey, that's a good idea.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
So a sensor activates a light and the light scares them and they run away.
Motion detector light.
Makes total sense.
Okay, that's a great idea. We might want to consider that too. Down
yeah, I never thought of that.
Yeah, I don't know. I never thought of that either. That's
great.
Eagle
Scout
the power of one of these brainstorming things
is
you get all kinds of ideas.
Yeah.
So, Sister Sarah, I am a year-round gardener. Awesome. I have bok choy, snow peas, onions, kale, lettuces, and spinach. Those are perfect crops right now in the early spring. I don't remember where you live, Sister Sarah, but man, you can go right from cool weather stuff into hot weather stuff. That's the wonderful thing about being able to grow year-round. You can always have something growing in the garden, so that's a lot of fun. Jamie Lim, growing tomatoes, peppers all year round. Wow. Now that's amazing. You must live in a pretty warm climate if you can do that. Yeah. Trying lettuce now, worried about the weather since it's about 80 degree weather. Yeah, that is tough for lettuce, but what really helps me get lettuce going in the heat is I do actually like to start it inside, get it going, get it nice and strong first, and then I usually like to plant it in a container because that way I can move the containers into the shade, in and out of the heat, cover them up and kind of chase the shade or chase the sun. So give that a try and hopefully that'll help you grow some lettuce even during the hot weather.
We had someone from Singapore on and now I can't figure out how to scroll back up, man.
Oh, I think I might have seen that.
Sorry about
that.
Very cool. But I saw you from Singapore. Sorry, we just lost you a little bit there.
Okay. Hardcore gardener has squirrels, raccoons, skunks. I know he lives in the mountains in Northern California, so he probably has everything. Black bears. Oh my gosh, that's something I do not want to see in my garden. Chickens tear up a bit sometimes. I'm famous now, mentioned on the air. Hardcore gardener, we just love having you on, and I know you're dealing with animals all the time, and I don't know how you keep them out of your garden. Maybe you just plant extra for the animals. I don't know. You have to pop something in the chat and let us know. So from Singapore, always have 80 to 100 degree plus weather. Is that what you just read, Jerry? Jamie?
Yeah, I believe so.
Okay, awesome. Trial and error is always the way to go, and I couldn't agree with that more. I mean, that's how we learn. Don't be afraid of failure. I don't like to call it failures because it's never, ever a failure if you're experimenting and trying something new. It's just a learning experience. And you know what? You're having fun along the way. You're growing your own food. You're harvesting for your family. Even if you just get a small amount, that's what it's all about.
Yeah, just Absolutely. Give it a whirl. See what happens. That's how you learned a lot. And you still do,
yeah.
Right? You're always constantly just trying stuff.
Definitely. I'm always trying something new because it's fun. You know, you want to always have the fresh ideas coming, so it's always good to be trying something else. Okay, growing snow. Vaughn, growing snow. Want some? I'll share. Sure, Vaughn, bring it on out. You know what? People actually do that in California. They dump snow so that people can play in it.
People pay to have someone bring down snow in a dump truck.
Kind of crazy, I know.
And dump it in their parking lot at
it's
work.
It's not at my alley. I don't like
it's funny. All right, a few more, and then we're going to just open up to questions, and we'll wrap it up.
Oh, from Australia, Minion Prinsloo, waiting for the weather to cool down. So
yes.
You guys are just coming into your autumn, I believe.
Yes, that's right.
Finishing up your summer, coming into your autumn. So you're completely opposite us, so you're probably tearing out your summer crops and planting your fall crops. So that's a lot of fun. Hopefully you get some cool weather for those fall crops.
Very cool, Australia. Good
awesome.
To have you.
10 inches of snow on Saturday. Tony's gardening, growing 10 inches of snow.
Tony's gardening. Are
oh
they
my
on
goodness.
Instagram?
Tony's gardening. I'm sorry, Tony. I don't remember where you're from. Is it Canada, I think?
I think I follow
I'm not
them.
Sure.
Cool.
Okay. Very, very cool. All right. The only failure in gardening is not to try. DW, Marshall, I couldn't agree more. Go for it.
Well said.
Try it. Very well said. Here's to DW.
DW. that's funny.
Give it a go. And Tama from Malaysia.
Very
awesome.
Cool. Well, good. Let's open it up
That's
to some
awesome.
Questions. We'll wrap up here with 5 minutes or so of questions. Been a great time.
It was a lot of fun.
Just learning more about you all and, you know, just hear what you're excited. And some of you are just like, I love that. Someone said, can't wait to get their hands in the dirt. And, you know, a scratch they can't itch and that kind of thing. So it's been really fun just to hear that coming from you guys, too. So I feel like we know our audience even better after tonight. So that's good. So bring it on if you have some questions now about anything. And we'll wrap up here in a couple of minutes.
Hardcore Gardner just mentioned he has deer too. Chain link fence that doesn't stop the gophers. I trap them. Now we have a gopher issue here as well. So
he said the T word.
We're working on that. So Hardcore Gardner, maybe we're gonna have to get the T's out, right?
I think we bring Hardcore Gardner down here.
Yeah, because guess what, guys? They're marching down my back fence, which means they'll be yanking out my tomatoes, guys, and all kinds of stuff. Can't have that. So
I get home every day. I pull into the front yard and I see new holes and new mounds of dirt, and it just boils me inside to see our front lawn just getting torn up.
Worse when the garden's getting torn up.
Yep.
Okay, what part of California are you in? Mimi, we are in Southern California, so it stays nice and warm here most of the year, and we can grow something all year round. So is the beverage homegrown? Come on, you can tell us. No, I only wish I had this many grapes, but it is not homegrown. That would be fun, but I don't know if I would have time to do that. That was funny. Okay, hello world. I am in South Carolina, hitting over 80 degrees. Oh my gosh. Wow, I had no idea it was that warm there yet, or already. I hope my tomato and pepper plants grow fast and strong. Well, 80 degree weather is perfect for tomatoes and peppers, so you should be seeing some really good growth from those if your weather holds. Hopefully you don't get like a late frost or something, but hopefully you're okay by now. So Javier, sorry about that. Oh, Tony from New Hampshire. Okay, thanks, Tony. Javier has bananas and papaya, guava, and kiwi. Ooh. Oh my goodness. Soon to come to the family, mangoes all in Fresno.
Fresno?
Oh my goodness, you have all that going in Fresno? That's amazing. Because Fresno gets pretty cold, doesn't it?
I think.
Wow, but that's great.
They have a lot of agriculture up
that's
there.
That's true, they do. Very cool. Thanks for sharing that, Javier.
Yeah, cool, man.
Great. So any other questions Let's see. Oh, did I miss some?
Well, Aaron said something about lighting or something. I just kind of wanted to see because I'm experimenting with some lighting here tonight. Just bring the whole window down.
I don't know how to do that. Okay. Sorry, guys. So we're scrolling here. Aaron, the lighting in your video looks really good. How to get it to look so good? Well, ask camera guy here. He just invested in some new lights. So
yeah, I'm just trying some new lights.
Yeah.
Aaron.
He'll have to give you a lesson, Aaron. All right? We'll do a live stream just for you. All right.
Well, I will say this, though. I did get these lights because they're so lightweight and they're mobile. And that means we're going to do more stuff like this in the evenings in the garden.
Definitely.
So that's going to be all Benny's for you all. So we can all do this together, even maybe in the dark at night out here.
Yeah.
That'd be really fun.
Or from on location.
On location. And I will tell you guys this, that Callie Kim will be going on the road on a very special trip soon, and we are going to, we're gonna film it. So
it's gonna be fun. You guys will not want to miss that. It's coming up in April.
Cool.
Okay, you guys, it's gonna be fun. Okay, let's see here. Speaking of grapes, did I see that?
Sorry.
I know someone's gonna ask about my grapes. I'm having problems with my grapes.
Yeah, the grapes.
How are yours doing? Okay, Cat's mama. All right. So I kind of discovered that I didn't really discover, but I made a mistake with my grapes, guys. I didn't prune them when I was supposed to prune them, all right? I was supposed to prune them back in January. Well, things got busy. I didn't prune them. They're branching out and leafing out, but I think I'm going to have to go in and whack them and just prune them down and then kind of start over with them. So I don't know if I'll do a video on it because I'm going to be honest with you. I don't know what I'm doing with grapes.
No clue.
I'm totally experimenting here. So I wouldn't want to do a how-to video because I really wouldn't want to steer people the wrong way. I mean, we could do a live stream and just give a disclaimer or something that this might not be the right way to do it. But so anyway, that's how my grapes are doing. We'll have to get back to that at another time. So thanks, Cat's Mama, for asking. Okay, let's see.
Well, Mark has asked, while you keep reading, I'll address Mark. Mark's question is, how long have we lived here? We've lived here 6 years now, over 6 years. But the backstory about our backyard is that we had a real, this backyard is a result of being on a backyard TV show where they come and they redo your backyard if you provide the labor here. So you can find something to talk about next while I tell the story. So our backyard was really just a gift from God, and we feel just very lucky to have been on this show. And we got all the people, and they provided the material. They had a designer come in and design our backyard for us. So
we did the work.
We have never been able to do this, but we did the work under their guidance. So that's how long we've lived here, and that's a little bit of a story of our backstory on our backyard.
Okay, I have a question here from Chini the Great. Hi, Chini. Thanks for joining us, about cabbages. And Chini says, I sowed my cabbage seeds and they were growing well. When I transplanted them into slightly larger containers, they all died in a few hours. What did I do wrong? Okay, Chini, I'm wondering if you might have transplanted them and then put them out in the sun right away. Because when you transplant something, you really need to keep it in the shade for a day or so, because it will go through transplant shock. It really has to get used to the new environment that you're putting it in. So I definitely recommend transplanting in the shade. Just get some more going again, not a big deal. And hopefully that'll help you for next time. But they shouldn't die in a few hours if you keep them in the shade, unless you maybe put them in the really hot sun. So hopefully that'll help you next time. Okay, let's see. Can you plant marigold seedings deep like tomatoes? And this is from Incredibaloo. Okay. Yes, tomatoes you definitely want to plant deep, but marigolds, you do not have to do that. Now, the only reason why I might plant them deep is if they were kind of leggy and just needed that extra support. But typically, you'd want to plant them just up to the level of the soil. Like I plant mine in little peat pellets. I have a whole bunch going right now. I would just place the peat pellet in the soil, and then cover it up to the level of the top of the peat pellet, if that makes sense. You don't need to plant them deep. And marigolds, by the way, are absolutely gorgeous flower. They're a good deterrent for pests, because the pests don't like that smell. So plant a bunch of marigolds around your yard, and they grow like crazy, and they're very heat and drought tolerant too.
All right, let's go a few more minutes, yeah?
Sure. D.W. Marshall said, great garden therapy session.
yeah, it is
garden therapy. It's fun to chat over with other gardeners. It's really a lot of fun. Okay, let's see. There's some other questions in here. What number bottle of wine are you on, Christy?
We're lightweight.
This is the first one, and it was only about this full when we started. So we barely drank in a glass. Okay. That's all. I promise you, Christy. All right. You're welcome, Chini. Hopefully that'll help. Okay. Going to try grow bags for tomatoes this year. Okay. Grow bags work great for tomatoes. Of course, my favorite is the Smart Pots. And one reason I like them is they're super durable. Provide you a lot of space, but yeah, that's a great way to add to your outdoor gardening space, no matter what types of grow bags you're using. So go for it. Absolutely wonderful idea. Okay, let's see if there's any other questions here in the traps. I'm reading Hardcore Gardener. Excuse me. He says he uses He says he uses the Maccabee style traps with a juicy carrot.
The juicy carrot on the bale.
Sorry, guys.
All right, we'll have to Google that. I don't really know what that means. That's hunter language.
I think I swallowed a bug.
Yeah, the bugs are
went right in my throat.